Hello everyone and welcome to my Coronation Street official. I hope everyone is having a wonderful day. Before we begin, please hit the subscribe button and give this video a thumbs up. Fans have rumbled about what is going on with Lauren. Viewers of Coronation Street believe they have found the terrible truth about Lauren Bolton's unknown boyfriend. Over the last 6 months, ITV viewers have seen the unhappy teen talk about her mysterious affluent boyfriend. Lauren, played by Kate Fitton, has yet to disclose any information to any of her friends despite being continuously questioned, except that she claims he is loaded. She has also displayed a number of things that the mysterious man appears to have purchased for her, but is there more to her secret affair than meets the eye? Lauren discussed the mystery man with her companions on her most recent trip to the cobbles. As her former lover Max Turner planned a little friendly gathering at his home, his girlfriend Sabrina was left begging Lauren to invite her partner along so they could get to know each other. Later, when Sabrina arrived at Max's house with her brother Gav, Lauren was already seated, but no plus one could be seen. Sabrina then asked Lauren whether he would be joining them later, but she informed everyone that he was working late and couldn't make it, an excuse that the wayward adolescent has previously made. When asked for more, Sabrina replied, "Maybe another time then." Lauren appeared to pull an uneasy face, which aroused concern that not everything was as she said. As the evening progressed, the pals were spotted speaking until Lauren appeared to respond to a message on her phone. She hopped up, putting on an exuberant display, and announced that he had asked to meet and hang out now that he had finished his work. But the remainder of the group remained skeptical, speculating that something was wrong. Many admirers seemed to feel the same way, as they expressed their sorrowful notion that Lauren had made him up and there was no lover at all. They took to X, previously Twitter, to express their belief that Lauren's boyfriend could be fictitious. A number of people wrote, "I'm still not convinced this mystery boyfriend of Lauren's is even real #Corey. Another added, "Lauren is lying about her boyfriend again, #Corey. Lauren has had a difficult time on Coronation Street and has faced difficulty after trouble throughout her first year in Weatherfield. From a failed romance with Max to an attempt to sleep with Roy Cropper, Lauren's life does not appear to be slowing down anytime soon." Coronation Street fans are outraged by Sarah Platt's harsh remarks about ex Adam Barlow. The businesswoman, played by Tina O'Brien in the ITV soap, spent the night with mobster Damon Hay despite the fact that he kidnapped and attempted to murder her ex Adam. But when Adam saw Damon leave Sarah's flat, he was devastated. Later, when he learned from DD that Damon had been involved in a violent altercation in jail while seeing his murderous brother Harvey, he lost control. He walked up to the Platt family supper and vented out his wrath on Sarah. "I don't want him staying over again," he explained to a perplexed Sarah. "I don't want him around when Harry is there. If I see you near that little boy, you'll know about it." But before Adam could react, Sarah said, "He's not even your son." The Platts were outraged by her remarks, and Adam was distraught because he was Harry's only father figure. Nick informed her it was a low blow, and Gail tutted her way through it, leaving fans shocked. One person wrote, "Sarah really is a nasty piece of work." A second said, "That was a low blow, Sarah," and a third agreed, "He raised you as well as a father could, Sarah, you ungrateful woman." Another user commented, "He's not even your son." Sarah's response to Adam was really demeaning, very low. This viewer added, "Sarah is treating Adam like crap. She knows Harry isn't Adam's son, but he treats him like one nevertheless." Later, Adam made a risky decision. He approached Damon's brother Harvey and offered him a deal. He would get him out of prison in exchange for Damon's permanent removal. Harvey accepted the offer, but will Adam come to faces the possibility of being killed off. This week, Adam Barlow confronts Harvey Gaskell in a desperate attempt to finally get rid of his adversary Damon Hay. But how will his deal with the devil pan out for the Coronation Street solicitor? Could the Platts face even greater trouble? The troublemaker takes his bullying to the next level. Mason Radcliffe has been bullying Liam Connor and other schoolchildren for several weeks. Tired of the harassment, Liam makes a desperate attempt to teach the Coronation Street bully a lesson. Will this work? Liam Connor, Charlie Renshaw, is being abused by his schoolmate Mason Radcliffe, Luca Tulin, and his parents are powerless to intervene. After witnessing the young kid being held at knife point, Many startled ITV viewers thought that Liam's life was in danger, and the small youngster is plainly terrified. Next week, Mason refuses to give Liam a break, and the child attempts to avoid his tormentor as much as possible. Gary Windus, Mikey North, and Maria Connor, Samia Longchambun, observe Liam leave for school, but as soon as their backs are turned, he rushes back to the flat for protection. Liam then conceals his tracks by accessing the school's website and reporting himself absent due to illness. However, his secret plan is soon exposed when, in the cafe, Maria informs Gary that the school has called and informed them that they haven't seen Liam in a week. In other sequences, Liam attempts to throw a sickie once more, but Maria is wiser and insists that he attend school. Maria sees Liam come on the bus but is perplexed when Dylan Wilson, Liam McChain, gets on and completely ignores her son. As the bus rolls away, Maria notices Liam has left his phone behind and follows him to the school gate. Liam is horrified to be seen with his mother at school, unaware that Mason is filming them. Later, Mason informs Dylan that Liam is a weed and would make him pay. Mason strikes again, snatching Liam's phone and forcing him to plead for it back. He taunts him before refusing to hand it over, as the other youngsters laugh. Terrified and humiliated once more, Liam rushes away and heads towards the school exit. Unfortunately, Mason catches up and grabs him, putting him against a wall. In desperation, Liam activates the fire alarm, but how will he explain his reasoning? Helen Flanagan reunited with her mother and sister from Coronation Street for a wellness session, including a Strictly Come Dancing champion. The Rosie Webster actress, 33, was overjoyed to meet her old friends Sally Dynevor and Brooke Vinson at a Sculpt Wellbeing event in Manchester. Helen dressed conservatively, opting for a full-length kilt, gray pullover, and leggings instead of her barely clad social media looks. She avoided cosmetics and wore her hair in a sloppy top knot. Sally donned a stylish camel coat, while Brooke stood out in a quirky throwback jacket with bright colors. The group smiled as they posed for photos outside the ABC Dome. Brooke's cousin, Strictly Come Dancing champion Ellie Leach, as well as Sally's lookalike daughter Hattie, were all in attendance. Helen hinted last year that a comeback to Corey was in the works before appearing on I'm a Celebrity All-Stars. She last appeared on the Cobbles in 2018, after which she took a break from television to raise her three children, Matilda, 8, Delilah, 5, and Charlie, 3. Helen acknowledged in an interview with OK that she had spoken with Corey executives and expressed a strong wish to repeat her part. She stated, "I'd like to see Rosie become a mother. I'd love to channel that. I'd like her to come back with a baby she hadn't told Sally about. Sally would make a fantastic grandmother." Last year, when camping in South Africa for I'm a Celeb, she revealed her poor behavior on the soap set. She admitted, "I used to get in trouble all the time because of my false tan. I would be really pale one moment and then brilliant orange the next. If you do things like that, people go completely insane. They flip if the continuity changes in the middle of a scenario." Helen succeeded Emma Collins, who had played Rosie from 1990 to 1999, in the role. However, she has only appeared on occasion since taking a sabbatical in 2012 to explore other possibilities. Thanks for watching. If you like this video, so please don't forget to subscribe my channel and don't miss any update.